So creating an amazing website that actually drives results doesn't have to be a big mystery. In the next few minutes, I'm going to show you my exact 7-step process I use to go from website concept to launch. And in the end, I will show you my Figma board that you can just clone to start working on your own projects. So let's dive in. Hey friends, my name is Raphael and I'm a Webflow expert and designer based in Austria. I started my own web design business 2 years ago, and on this channel I'm documenting the journey and what I've learned along the way. Today I want to walk you through the exact process I use for every single client. This not only gives you a great streamlined process, but it also makes sure that the final website is very polished and exceeds the client's expectations. So whenever I get a new client, I basically follow the exact same 7-step process. And so let's break it down step by step. Phase 1, discovery. And so this is where I learn about the client's business, goals, and their target audience. It's all about understanding their vision and what they want to achieve with their new website. The duration of this phase is typically between 1 day and 1 week, depending if the project is very complex or not. In this phase, I really ask a lot of questions and really want to dig deep into what it is they're looking for. For example, I ask about their most important business objectives, what their target audience really is, and their long-term vision for the brand. And basically, this sets the foundation for all the other phases that will follow later. And so practically, there's two ways that you can do this. I either let my clients fill it out themselves, or we complete this phase together in a paid workshop session. And so this is great because it sets the direction for the next steps, but it also builds trust in the beginning because it shows your client that you know your stuff and you're not just designing things, but you also have a clear process in place. At the end of this phase, you should have a basic sitemap ready. And this sitemap should pretty much answer 3 basic questions. What major pages will the site have? How are they linked together? And what content goes on what page? As soon as I have the goal for this phase completed, I can move on to the next phase. So phase 2 is what I call the research phase, and this is a crucial step for the web design process. Basically, what we do here is we gather inspiration from many different sources and we put them together in a way to create like a first visual direction. And typically this takes like a half day to up to a week if the project is very complex. So first I start by brainstorming adjectives or values that I want the brand to associate with. For example, words like warm, organized, industrial, or edgy. And so what this does is aligns the brand identity with the future website to really align them together. For instance, a tech startup might want a more innovative, sleek feeling, while a local bakery might prefer their website to be more warm and inviting. Next up, I collect reference material from many different sources. This typically includes online platforms like Dribbble, Behance, and Landbook, but also like inspiration from the real world, like museums and books can be very important, or even movies. So there's really no limit to where you can get inspiration from. And so how I really do this is what I call micro research. And so I break everything down into really, really small components, basically like very specific elements of web design, and I research everything bit by bit. For example, I have a section in Figma just for layout inspiration, also a specific section for just colors and interactions and buttons and everything that's needed to move the visual direction forward. And so once I have collected everything that I need and I have like a little bit of an idea how the visual direction is gonna look like, I put these favorite elements together in like a more refined mood board, or what's sometimes called like a stylescape. And so what's great about this is you can present this and get an early like commitment from the client, because if you get a lot of resistance from the client later, it will be even harder to change things because you already developed the site. So it's best to get feedback as early as possible in the process. And so the goal of this phase is to present the client a like stylescape or a more refined mood board, which will lay the foundations also for the steps up ahead. Phase 3, structure. This phase is all about building the structure and creating the wireframes, which will basically lay the groundwork for the future site. And this is a step I really love to do because you can really think out the whole user experience and optimize for conversions without actually designing the site. This takes usually about 1 to 2 days maximum, so it's a pretty quick step most of the time. And so first I create the site structure for all the necessary sites and the elements there. At this stage, I'm more focused on the overall layout and less on the actual design, which will come at a later stage. And wireframes are basically like the blueprint of a website. And what I really love to use to streamline this process is called Reloom. But they have a lot of like this pre-built components that you can use to like piece the wireframe together, which really saves a lot of time. And I think it's a fantastic resource to like build low fidelity wireframes really quickly. And so the goal of this stage is again to create a low fidelity wireframe and ideally present it to the client so you have less resistance going forward. And if you've completed this, you can move on to the next phase. Phase number four is visual design. So here we basically turn the wireframes into a visual design and ideally bring the brand to life. What I like to do first basically is to define all the color styles and text styles in Figma and make them really align with the brand. Ideally, as I said before, you should already have aligned these styles before with the client, which makes the whole process a lot simpler. And so the next step would be to like really build out from basically from the wireframe that you built before, to build out all the sections really how you want them to, which of course can take a lot of effort, but this is really where your main core of work as a designer lies. So you should ideally have fun with that. And what you can do here is basically you go through all the elements of the site and design them step by step. For this, I most often like to not start with the hero because the hero is like the most work most of the time, but rather you can start with like designing all the buttons, all the texts and all the subsections. And basically at the end, you should have like a final web design that you can present to the client. And ideally, this should really be fleshed out. If you followed all the previous steps, the next step of development should be a lot easier because your client should have less resistance and your process is just a lot more streamlined. So phase number five is the build phase. This is where we turn a design we created before into an actual functional website. This involves building the site in Webflow and making sure it's responsive and it works across all the different devices. And so the first thing I like to do here is export all the assets that I'm gonna be needing from a design out of Figma into a folder that I can later upload to Webflow. And so the next step that I most of the time use is I clone the Reloom style guide, which helps me set up all the specific text styles and color styles very easily. And so what I start first most of the time to build is like the home site and to develop the header, footer, and like all the components that I'm gonna be needing, also the buttons. So depending on what your project timeline looks, it's best to have the most important things ready as soon as possible, like the main page, the hero section, and then the less important pages like the sub pages you can do after that. And so at this stage I fill in all the copy, all the contents like images and so on, and to have like a basic site setup. So when this is done, I typically add interactions and animations to the site. This can include like hover effects, scrolling animations, like smooth scrolling and so on, like all the tiny things that makes the site a little bit more unique. And when this is done, there's like the little bit tedious part but very important part to make it responsive on all the different sizes. And so what you don't want is your client checking out your new build site on their tiny iPhone SE or something and noticing that they can't access half of the contents. And so the goal for this phase is basically to have your site built ready and then you can move on to the next phase. Phase number six is the launch phase. So this is where the site finally goes live. And what we do here is we make everything great and ready for the audience to view. This typically involves some final checks and preparations before we connect the site to the main domain. And so this is typically the most exciting part for you and the client because everything that you've built so far is finally coming together and going out into the world. And so that's why I want to make sure that it's a successful launch. First up, what we do is we check SEO and metadata. We check all the page titles and the meta descriptions to make sure that we get a great SEO score and that the site can rank as high as possible. We also set the open graph title, description, and image, which is important for social sharing. Also important, we add the favicon, we remove the Webflow branding, and we definitely want to make sure that the style guide is hidden so it's not accessible to the outside world. This is also the stage where we let our clients spell check the website to make sure there's no typos and that the content is all finalized. At this stage, we can also set up things like analytics, A/B testing with Google Optimize, for example, basically everything that we need going forward. And so when everything's done, we connect the client's domain and then we basically go live. We can also then immediately check the page speed and the page scores on different sites like PageSpeed Insights or Checkbot, what I really like to use. And so this really gives you the insights to optimize the site even further. If you want a deeper dive on preparing your site for launch with Webflow, I've made another video. So if you want, you can check that out. And so then we are basically in the last phase, which is phase number seven, post-launch. This is where we provide the client with continuous supported optimization over a longer period of time. This is a great opportunity, for example, to work on a retainer basis. And so two great things that you can do in this phase basically is to measure analytics with tools like Google Analytics or Matomo, where you can really monitor the user behavior and the key metrics, which can be great data points for your client's business. Second secret tip that I really like is you can actually do an online user test. So I sometimes do this with like a platform that's called User Brain. And what you do is you basically let the site get checked by different people. It's basically like a UX test. And this really helps in identifying the weak spots of the website and to really check if it's user friendly And this way you can improve the site a lot more than if you just do it by intuition. Also in this phase, it's really key to stay in touch with your client and to communicate on a regular basis. Maybe the client wants some content updates. Maybe they want to like build more subsites or to grow the website more. And so I think this is a great opportunity for like a long-term retainer basis, because they've already built that trust and launched their site, and they're probably willing to go on a longer journey with you together, which is a great thing. And so that's my 7-step process for delivering amazing websites for my clients. I hope you found this walkthrough helpful. And as a thank you for watching the video all to the end, and to help you streamline your design process, I'm giving you my Figma template away for free. And so this template is basically the same that I use for my real client project. There's everything on there, like the initial discovery questions. And of course, it's in Figma, it's fully customizable, so just fit it to your needs. So you can access the template fully for free, and I'll leave the link down in the description and let me know how you liked it. If you enjoyed this video, I've made a special Webflow playlist that you can check out to watch next. It features the videos that a lot of people have found very helpful, so check that out, and see you in the next video.